First of all, you need these files for installation. Check description box for the link. Open CPUZ software. Note the CPU code name. Download the EFI file according to your CPU code name. Open browser and search for Olerola. Click on EFI folders. Now download the EFI file for your system with the same CPU code name. Open Balina Etcher software. Click on Flash from File and select your macOS vanilla image. Open it. Connect your pen drive of minimum 16 GB storage and select your target USB. Now flash it. Open Mini Partition Tool. Now right-click on the EFI partition of your USB and change the letter. Hit OK and apply changes, then proceed with the prompts. Quit the software. Then run the File Explorer ++ software as administrator. Open EFI and delete all files in it. Then open the EFI folder that we downloaded and copy-paste the EFI folder. The bootable USB is ready now. Now restart your computer. Enter BIOS mode by holding the F2 key or delete key. Then disable the secure boot option. Disable Intel Platform Trust Technology under Peripherals tab. Save and exit the setup. Now enter boot menu by holding F12 key and select the flashed USB. Now click on Install macOS. Take Disk Utility. Choose Show All Devices option at the top. Then select the disk where you want to install macOS. Click on Erase and put a name, and choose macOS Extended Journaled Format, select GUID Partition Map Scheme, then hit Erase. Click Done and close the tab. Now click on Install macOS, then continue. Proceed with the prompts. Choose the disk and hit continue. This may take time. Now set up with your macOS interface. The macOS has been installed. Now there are few setups to boot your Mac without USB. Open the USB and go to Files. Then open Open Core Configurator. Now go to the top right corner of your macOS, and click on Open Core. Then mount the EFI partition of your USB drive. Then enter the password, and open the partition. Copy the EFI folder, and close the window. Once more take the open core, and mount the partition of your disk. Open it and delete the EFI folder in it, and paste the previously copied folder in it. Now remove your USB and reboot your Mac. Select the Mac disk. The macOS is now ready to use. Some of the graphics card may not work properly, so it is need to install a graphics driver. Check the description box for graphics installation video.